So, today we're heading off to Ghent, which is another city I've never visited before. Again, I'm amazed by the number of bicycles and how many people just leave them unlocked. That's why people in Europe get to have nice things. We can't even have shopping trolleys in the UK without them ending up at the bottom of a river. We took a bus from the train station into town and had fun looking at the shops. Then it was time for pizza and affogato, which is where you put coffee over ice cream. Harris and Rob took me to their favourite plant shop. Harris has recently started growing plants in the apartment, decorating their balcony with flowers and vines. They love to drop into this place when in Ghent, and it's easy to see why. It has an otherworldly feel to it, as though the plants live here and the people are just visiting. Thank you. my love of old buildings and churches, my friends took me off to see Ghent Cathedral, which is indeed a very old church. St. Bava's was originally a small wooden chapel dedicated to St. John the Baptist, first consecrated back in 942. Construction on the cathedral began around 300 years later. St. Bava is the patron saint of Ghent. This is a shrine inside the cathedral where people give thanks for miracles they have received. In olden times, they left hearts and devotional objects made of metal. Nowadays, there are many plastic plaques with messages of thanks left as ex voto. I think this is a relic of St. Bavo, possibly part of his arm, but it wasn't entirely clear. If you know, please drop it in the comments below. As with most cities in Europe, Ghent is a hotspot for hen parties. We took a wander past the castle, along the river, and found coffee in an old almshouse, which also used to be a school at one point. Then it was back out onto the street and into a traditional sweet shop. Walk down Graffiti Street. Most cities in Europe are covered in graffiti, so Ghent decided to offer a dedicated place for graffiti artists to play. It's really colourful and constantly changing, as new art is painted over the top of old art. It's become a local tourist attraction.
Another round won't save you.
I'm not sure what the ancient inhabitants of the city would have made of it. After that, we took a leisurely stroll along the riverside, then hopped on a train home for tea.